Hello, I'm KCRA 3 meteorologist Dirk Verdorn, and our weather pattern is changing a little bit. We had temperatures drop off a degree or two for your Sunday, and we'll continue to see another degree or two drop as we head into Monday. Little weak weather systems pushing through the Pacific Northwest, and you can see a lot of activity in through the Great Basin, so from Nevada, Oregon, on into Idaho and Utah. We have all this thunderstorm activity, while California, we're not seeing anything, just a slight cool down, and that's mainly because we have just an onshore breeze that's going to be coming through. But zoom out, and we can kind of take a look at the weather pattern. We can see that flow, just kind of trace the clouds going up, see it sweeping through here, and then coming down here, and moving in that direction. We have high pressure that's in place out here over the eastern Pacific, and so you can see that general flow, that circulation of low-level clouds is kind of rotating around this area of high pressure, going clockwise. Expect that to actually stay offshore through Monday as we have this next little wave coming through. That's this little weather system that's right in here. As that slides through, that'll keep temperatures, again, in the upper 70s, close to 80, so slightly above average. So this is the weather pattern. You can see that cooler air making its way through the Pacific Northwest and onto the Northern Rockies. And then once that moves out, boy, the warm air moves in. High pressure continues to build as we go through Tuesday, Wednesday, and by Thursday and Friday, with that ridge sitting right over top of us, temperatures will be climbing into the low 90s. So that's going to be the warmest weather so far this year that we've seen. And we'll see that again through Friday before it starts to back off a little bit by next weekend. So the overall pattern with the chance for rain, nothing really happening. We're looking at most of that staying to the north and sliding off to the east. High pressure builds, so we're not going to be seeing much in through Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Now what happens is we get later in the week, we could start seeing just some isolated afternoon showers popping up over the crest of the Sierra. Looks like it's starting Friday afternoon, then getting into Saturday afternoon, and then on into Sunday afternoon. And that's kind of a little bit more typical pattern that we would see with a little monsoon activity coming up from the south. Your Sierra forecast does include a bit of warming. We'll see temperatures in the mid, then upper 50s from Monday into Tuesday, and then Wednesday, lots of sunshine and temperatures in the mid 60s. And all that means is that that snow is going to be melting at a more rapid rate. And so we do have some areas of concern, and one of them is the Yosemite Valley. The Merced River there at Pohono Bridge is where we're expecting to see some flooding taking place as we get into later this week as those temperatures start to rise. You can see the pattern here of melting and then the flooding, and then you have it kind of getting cold at night, so the water starts to go down and then it goes back up, and you see this just diurnal pattern with the warming of the day getting more melting, and then it slows down at night as the temperatures cool off. And so right now the forecast has 10 p.m. Thursday that it's expected to get up to flood stage there in the Yosemite Valley. So we'll have to watch that through the week and see how that develops. 7-day forecast showing lots of sunshine with temperatures in the upper 70s to lower 80s on Monday, mid 80s on Tuesday, upper 80s by Wednesday, and then lower 90s by Thursday and Friday. That's a look at your weather. For all your weather needs, make sure you turn to KCRA.